Hello all. An architectural thesis is the most important part of a BArch student's life. It is the pinnacle of the work that they do in college. But architecture thesis, once you're out of college and you know after the craze for some months, you get into your life and you kind of forget about it. Forget about it as in, you know, you don't get an opportunity to talk about it so much. But every architecture student has fallen in love with the work that they do in their architectural thesis. So it's very important to get to know the architectural thesis of many students. So today we have with us Shivani Badola, who is the final year student who's just actually completed her final year at the School of Planning and Architecture, New Delhi. So how are you, Shivani?
I'm very good, sir.
Very nice. Welcome. So, you know, Shivani is kind of creativity freak. She's into digital painting, she's into biomimicry, she's into hand sketching, and also, you know, likes to read, travel, and write poetry. So Shivani, what was the topic of your thesis?
So my topic is performing arts center. Like with this thesis, I mainly wanted to show how we can express culture through architecture. Like it is like a hub which is for preservation and dissemination of knowledge regarding historical as well as modern culture and art forms. So it's like a link which links the history and modern with culture.
Wow. So, you know, without any further ado, I would like to request you to directly start sharing your presentation and, you know, show us all the great work that you have done.
So, as I said, like my thesis mainly about expression of culture through architecture. So I would like to say that three P's, that is people, pace and place, are very important to express any culture or to just feel any culture. So majorly, it was like, why is there a need to express culture? Like, okay, we are saying I want to make a performing arts center or maybe a cultural center, but why is there actually a need to express the culture? So as we all know that India is a very diverse country and it has so rich heritage and art forms. So culture does not become important socially or emotionally, but also economically culture is very important in our country. So it improves the quality of life and it shapes the image of a place. But because of the globalization and maybe the influx of Western culture, we Indians are at the verge of losing our own culture. Like we do not give that much importance to our culture. And this is leading to a mechanical lifestyle. Also, culture and art forms today live as a niche or as an alternative system. We do not give it that much importance. So even our master plan, here shows that from 1961, public, semi-public was 25%, but till 2021, it became just 15%. So it is reducing to a great extent. So in such scenario, it is very important that we adapt a culturally sensitive design, which would help to attain diverse but cohesive society. Like our society may be diverse. I'm not promoting any one particular culture. So it can be a diverse, but it should be a cohesive society which include everything.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So this thing can be achieved by performing arts center. So what is performing arts center majorly is it is a place where performers express their artistic expression. Like as I am into artistic field, like I love to do sketching and all. So it is very important to express your artistic expression. And when it is done to live audience through different art forms like dance, drama, theater, all these comes under performing arts center. And why I chose my place, like the place for my thesis as Gurgaon, because Gurgaon has many emerging artists coming up. Like, but there is no performing arts center over there. Like here the map shows all the performing arts center is in Delhi and Gurgaon actually doesn't have any. So the people or the artists have to travel all the way to Delhi to show their talent or to just bring their artistic expression in front of people. So the cultural center in Gurgaon becomes a very important place for the artist over there and also for the upcoming people who wants to pursue artist as their like maybe as their hobby or their career option. So that's why I wanted to make the performing arts center in Gurgaon.
Very nice.
then my the aim of my proposition, like the aim of my thesis, like why I actually want to go about this thesis is to develop a continuity, because Gurgaon, as we now we just see it as a hub for this IT hub center, or maybe you, if you go there, the architecture over there has this huge glass buildings which does not invite people, or it is not like a, it does not give continuity to people. So so that the people can come and there can be relationship and movement can be maintained among them. So I wanted to have this in Gurgaon especially. So here we'll develop a continuity between that which was, that which is, and that which will be. So it connects all the three tenses, or all the three past, present, and future. And this project will initiate a large cultural shift. Like there will be a cultural shift, and there will be a key for balanced individual and holistic lifestyle as a whole.
Yes, 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 absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah. So like to coming into place, like cultural center or performing arts center can have many spaces for performances. Like it does not actually for performance, performing arts space. Being an architect, I also know that there are like the performing art does not need a very specific or special place to happen. It can happen on a like maybe a recital hall or maybe a place of worship, or it has different spaces where it can happen. So instead of taking okay, it should happen only in auditorium, I try to sense those places and try to bring them into my thesis. So here I divide like the spaces required for performances and what all spaces, like it can be house of worship, it can be teaching spaces, it can be recital hall, it can have theater performances, and all these, and what all spaces can these performances happen. And then also about the theaters, like for different type of performances, like if it is a puppetry, if it is a music, if it is dance, all require some different kind of tangible, intangible aspects within them.
Yes.
So they all require different kind of spaces. So I have studied about different kind of spaces or different like what all type of theaters might be required for different performing arts. Maybe for classical something else is required, and for Western something else is required. So merging all those and coming up with a single place which is more flexible and can accommodate all the all type of performances is majorly what I studied in my research. Also about the, that was about the quantitative aspects, but also talking about the qualitative aspects, like the expression of culture can be through symbols, it can be through rituals, it can be through practice, through values. So all those things, can, if we try, if we bring all these things into a place, then only people can express their feelings or express their artistic expression freely. So that was what about expression of culture I meant, how people are expressing their culture through what all means, or through what they can have the sense of belongingness to a place, or a sense of greatness to a place they can have. Absolutely. So it can be through sociability. Yeah. So it can be through sociability, access and linkages. There should be comfort. They should feel comfortable to express. Like if there is a lot of restriction and all, a person cannot freely do anything over there.
Yes.
So all those things are very important in performing arts center. Yes. As a qualitative means.
Yes.
Then we studied about the like the case studies so that we understand the basic principles, what are required in a performing arts center, and what all are the spaces specially required in a performing arts center. Because apart from the main space, which is like an auditorium or maybe a multipurpose hall, apart from that, there are some other spaces like costume hall, or maybe some small spaces like green room spaces and other library spaces and all, which are supporting spaces. They are also very important.
Yes.
For a person who is actually going to perform.
Absolutely.
So all the, that has been studied from the case study, and then the framework has been developed. Okay, I'll study the case studies from details of the buildings will be there. Then there will be site details, user detail. But most importantly, there will be architectural component, like how actually people try to express their culture or how they try to express their feeling through architectural components, like what can be the identity, how they can express things, what can be the material used or the structural system. and how can be the historical precedents they can take forward so that people feel a sense of belongingness or a connectivity towards the place.
Absolutely.
So apart from that, like, there was some major learnings from the case study, which tells the how the built and open merges into one another, or where, how is the connectivity is there. But yet, like, apart from connectivity, privacy should also be maintained. So there is connectivity, people can go to all the places, but yet there is privacy which is supposed to be maintained. And then there it is, how it can make public inclusive so that people are getting attracted not just to come and see the performances, but also use that place as their own. Like, yeah, they can come and maybe in the evening or during other times, they can come and just roam around over there. And then it can become an active place, because the site actually has the offices around. Like, Gurgaon actually is famous for IT offices. Yes. So the space is mainly active during the day, which makes it more vulnerable place, or more place for where the crime can occur at, yes, during the nights or during the evenings. So if we try to make the place as more vibrant, not just architecturally, but also by how people are using it.
Wow. Yes.
Like, because architecturally, you can do many things to make a place vibrant, maybe colors or maybe put other things. But if the people are not using, like, people, they have this special sense with the place. If they feel that they belong to the place, they'll start using it in other way, and that makes the place more vibrant.
Absolutely.
So how people are using it, all these things make the place more inclusive, and then the crime rates and all can be reduced.
Absolutely.
Then they should.
So, you know, just to interrupt you, so this is a very important, yes, point that you have mentioned. You know, that's the crime prevention through environment design, where just by increasing the activity, you increase the natural surveillance of a place and it becomes crime free. So thank you. Go ahead, Shivani.
Yeah, because being a girl, even the cameras, like, if people will say, okay, we have camera here, this place is safe. Actually, we do not feel that safe. But if the activities are happening and people are there and they are enjoying and all, then we won't mind going at that place. Like, we won't feel that much fear in going to that place.
Absolutely.
So that was the sense which I wanted to create. Also, to make any place inclusive, or where it attracts people, or it attracts all kind of people, not just the youth of the place, but also from children to the old age, everyone should come to the place. So comfort, connectivity, control of ownership, like, they should have a feeling of ownership over their place. Then there should be engagement with the space. Like, people, if they're using that space, they should have this kind of engagement with the place. And then design and aesthetics, all these play a very important role.
Absolutely.
Then talking about the site, my site is actually in Gurgaon Sector 53. So
is it a live site?
Yes, it is. This is a live site, and this is proposed for cultural arts center only. But then the government couldn't have the money to develop it yet. Like, this proposal has been given 8 years back.
Okay. Yeah. Very interesting shape of the site. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. So the main road abutting the site actually goes and merges the golf course road and to the right, and sector 44 on the left. And site area is approximately 24,600. Built up is 35,700, and ground coverage is 7,000 square meter, which is like 28% of the site. So that means I have a lot of green spaces in my area, because performing arts center or maybe all these spaces actually require the greens on the ground so that people can enjoy.
Okay, understood.
Then this shows the public and pedestrian and vehicular movement especially. So my site actually covers from all the side, it is covered with road. So it has good connectivity, like from all the side, people can actually enter into the into the site.
Absolutely.
And then the mainly user group who are using the place is artists, like the people, performers or the artists, shopkeeper, visitor, tourist, office people. And as I said, all the people from a small kid to the old people, everyone is using the space.
Absolutely.
Then I actually divided the all the areas. Like I have two auditoriums, one multipurpose hall, then one training center and one residence. So I divided everything into three parts, public, semi-public and private. So the public included where the general public and everyone can go and visit. The semi-public has some restriction. And then the private is like residences where only the people who are residing over there are allowed.
Okay.
So actually the residences, like in front of the residences and all, also other people are allowed, but then there is still some privacy which is maintained for the residential people over there.
Absolutely.
So this shows the SWOT analysis, which tells about the strength, weakness, opportunity and threat from site analysis, research and technological point of view. So it majorly tells that if we develop this cultural center, then it can make the area active and vibrant, as I said, and it will respond to all the tangible and intangible factors, and it will develop multi-sensory experience for the people who are residing over there.
Great.
So the main drivers and concept for my thesis is majorly that vehicular, as I said, the vehicular
the
role
left
is
side
along
diagram.
The
can you zoom in a little bit? The left side diagram.
This one.
Yes, the evolution. Yeah. Little more. Just pan it to the left.
Yeah.
Yes.
So this shows that the vehicular road is actually on the all the periphery. So people can enter from any side of the design. And then if we see the north-south orientation should be there because north has glare-free light. So all the places, because it's a performing arts center, natural light is very important. And
yes,
there is learning center. So in the classrooms also, natural light is very important. Also natural light... itself with the performances, like with the dance and drama, people try to use natural light also as a prop. So coming of natural light is very important. So the building was supposed to, was majorly north-south oriented, and then the climate and wind direction has been given importance. So what, like from where the wind is coming and all, and my built form was directed from the built mass, from the wind and from the site boundary.
Right.
Also, the division, the basic division of public, private and semi-public has been done on the basis of the privacy of the site itself. So from on the site, the right side, this side is the Wazirabad Band, which is known as the lung of Gurgaon. So this area is like a eco-restoration area. And this side is the majorly the areas which has petrol pump, then some restaurant and other spaces. So this area is more public. This has more like noise and everything. And this is more private, which is more quieter edge. So I divided my site in such a way that public comes over the left side and the private area comes towards the right side, so that the private can actually look into the green spaces and can feel that quiet and nice, serene environment over there.
Okay.
And then as the site is in Delhi, as the site is in Gurgaon or like the nearby Delhi.
Nearby.
So the climate, if we keep the courtyard spaces, then it will be much more better for the climatic, like from the climatic view. So the courtyards, the major thing was courtyards. Courtyards were given on the in the center of the place, and the level of publicness and privateness has been divided, and there are private and public courtyards that are given here.
Great.
So the green like this shows just, yeah, so the segregation, the pedestrian entry. So the vehicular is only kept on the periphery so that the pedestrian from the middle does not have any restriction. Like they do not fear, they have this freedom to roam anywhere or to go anywhere without the fear of vehicles coming in their way.
Yeah.
And also the cultural center, all the cultural places are actually connected by this public corridor, so that people does not, the public corridor helps in connecting all the places and also safeguard the people from the rain and from the heat of the sun.
Okay.
And also the green areas shape the built form around it. So the my built form is actually built form is not shaping the green areas over here. The green areas itself is shaping the built form, because the green area is a major part of which is attracting people to come and attend all the play come and attend to the all the places in the performing arts center.
Absolutely.
So it there is hierarchy in greens also.
Okay.
Then building around, so this is a 3D view for my project. And here the building actually, building is around the greens, which makes the design biocentric. And it helps in equal growth of people, nature, along with architecture. So here just not the architecture is growing, but people and nature along with architecture is growing.
Right.
And then there is a chance for cross-learning. Because it's a performing arts center, people would love to come and interact with the artist over there and try to learn from each other. So cross-learning is very important in such a place. So there is a chance for cross-learning between different spaces, between different disciplines, along with interconnected spaces, which are either visually or physically they are interconnected. And then there is chance for cross-interaction between them. So the design is majorly flexible and it is multi-purpose in use.
Great.
So this shows the design development. So from the whole thesis semester, I started with this one and then it goes forward and how I came to my final design. So majorly we start with a prime concepts, like some concepts, like for me it was courtyard or maybe designing according to the site, climate, etc. Like all these are the primary concepts or primary drivers, and then we start evolving on our design.
Right.
So so talking about my final design, so the final design has the zoning. So this is my development. So we have the site, then I actually extruded in this site how much area can I build according to 28% of ground coverage. I have to carve out the green spaces. So I carved out the green spaces like according to the hierarchy of greens, then making the built open relationship and the porous blocks so that the built can interact with the greens and the greens can interact with the built, and then finally making the porous entries and connectivity to the site. So that is how my site got developed or my design got developed. And talking about the zoning area. So these two are the performing arts center. So this is like public area. This becomes semi-public and here is the private area. So
right.
The public areas actually, these two are the auditoriums.
Right.
This is multi-purpose hall so that the people from the learning center can also use this when not in use,
yeah.
Or it can also be used for smaller performances.
Right.
And then this is the food court. So food court becomes the center because everyone is using the food court. Like even the people from the accommodation or the hostel block is going to use the food court. Even the people who are from the learning center going to use it. And even the people who are coming to the public spaces are also
right.
going to use the food court. So food court becomes
right.
the center, but still it is at the back because people who actually want to go and eat, they'll go anyhow.
Yes.
So I try to keep the front edge as the majorly as auditoriums and majorly as learning center so that it attracts more people to come in.
Okay. Great.
Then talking about the connectivity, as I said already, the roads is only on the periphery. The pedestrian is majorly at the center, so it connects everything. And green is majorly on a hierarchical basis. So it tells, so there are majorly three drop-offs. So people does not get, like there are not too many entry exits so that people get confused. There is one entry, but then there are three drop-offs. So one for the public, so whoever is coming can get drop-off over here. The people who are coming to the learning center can get drop-off over here. And the people who are coming for residences can get drop-off here. So there are three drop-off, one for public, semi-public and private.
Great.
Then talking about the orientation and massing, my building is majorly north-south oriented. So north is in this direction, upper, like the top left side. So this is the north direction. So majorly the built form is north-south oriented. so that the glare free light can come in and there will be less heat gain. Because if a place is very nice in looking, but if it does not, it is not comfortable enough for the people to go and enjoy, or maybe climatically, or it is too hot for the people to stay, people wouldn't want to go there. Absolutely. So it is very important to manage the climate with the places. Like, if, even if you give awesome spaces in the building, but that climatically it is not suitable, then yes, people are not going to use it.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So self-shading massing, and so like all the courtyards are also self-shaded by the building built form around it. So even if the people are using these courtyards in the, like during the afternoon, like 4 to 5 or something, then also the spaces remain mostly shaded. Yes. So people can actually use all the courtyards during all the time of the day.
Yes.
And then the build is designed according to the wind direction. So the wind direction is coming from here and going like this direction. So all the build form is 30 to 45 degree angle to the wind direction.
Yes.
So that it maximizes the air movement and cross ventilation can happen easily inside the buildings.
Right.
And east and west is majorly either protected by buffer spaces or maybe by shaded walls, by jali walls and all those things.
Great.
And in case of facade system, on the north side, because north side does not have glared light or so much heat, so we can have like large this glass facades which let in glare-free light inside. Okay. But because it's a performing arts center, I did not wanted the voice or the noise pollution to come in or go out from my built form. So I have this planters which are built on the slab level in the northern facade to subdue the noise.
Okay.
On the east side, jali wall and louvered walls are there to maintain the ventilation and diffuse light and to cut down the glare.
Yes.
On the south, it is mostly solid wall, which has horizontal chajjas and jali pattern. And on the west, it is mostly solid because west is the most hottest region. Like it's very glared light which comes in from the west. So it is mostly solid walls and vertical louvers to cut down wherever required. And also the planters are kept on the west side so that it cools down the air.
Hmm.
Then talking about my the site plan. So when person enters from here, they actually get down and can collect. So there is a corridor spaces which connect both the auditoriums. So all the transition spaces happen over there where they can collect ticket. They can have this clock room. They can have this information center and other things. And even for the people who are coming for the learning center, if they are coming for the admin, they can directly go to the admin. But then students do not want to actually go and meet the admin and then go to the learning center daily. So yeah, they have the particularly their private entry from where they can go to the learning center above, which is above the library and admin. So the learning center is an L shape. So from here, the students can visit. Similarly, in case of hostel block also, this forms the student hostel and this forms the teacher's hostel. So that they both can have a separate entry and they can stay separate even though they are connected. And in this also, the boys hostel is this side, girls hostel is over the right, and center part are the common spaces like mess and common lounge, so that even they are connected but yet they are separated, they maintain their own privacy.
Yes.
Over there, so privacy is maintained. Here, like the triangular part over here, this actually forms, so this becomes the public area, this becomes the private area. So the triangle over here, this actually forms the connection between the private and public area, and it actually has the pergola above. On the upper floor, it has pergola, which makes this place serene and beautiful. So when the people are actually using that space, they can actually feel the difference between the public and private and an interconnected space. So the interconnected space has water element in it, or it has the pergola element which forms the shadow pattern on the ground and all those things.
Okay.
Also, the built form is very porous and flexibility of movement is provided. So as you can see, from all the places, actually people can just move in or move out. So there is a lot of flexibility. So it is not like a very directed design. So people can choose to go wherever they want according to the flexibility or according to their own wish, and they can explore different things. So that every time when they're coming, it's not like, okay, first we are going here, then here. And then after coming once, they're like, ab to sab pata hai us jagah ka, so why do we need to go again? Okay. So every time when the people come, they'll have different kind of experience over there.
Okay. Okay.
And this makes the place more friendly and happy.
Right.
Then there are different plans, like upper floor plans.
Right.
Then talking about the sections, majorly, like the sections actually showed the both the auditoriums. So this is cutting through both the auditoriums. And it shows the balcony seating and the truss system, which has been used in the majorly in the sections. Then talking about the like this one, it actually tells about the this one is the auditorium. This is the multipurpose hall and this is the training center. So this majorly shows us the porous greens which is there. So like there are porous cutouts from where people can easily go in and come out. So on upper floor, there is building, but on the ground floor, majorly for the movement, porosity has been taken great importance. So I have given the porous cutouts on the ground floor. And because there is a lot of pedestrian movement, I actually put this piezoelectric plate. So these plates are like when actually person places their foot on it, it generates electricity. So because according to the calculation, daily 4,600 people are using this place. So major like some part, at least 10% or 15% of the electricity can easily be developed by just the people who are walking on the on these plates. So piezoelectric plates have been used in the public areas, and also because these many people are using the place, they will easily produce 325 kgs of waste daily. So if they're producing this much of food waste, 325, so we can easily turn this into compost and then can use in the green spaces, because there are so many green spaces. So instead of taking manure from outside, we can use this and try to use this as a plus point for our design. So it's mostly like a circular design where nothing is coming from out and nothing is going out. Like all the waste product has been used, utilized inside the building itself.
Great.
So I have used eco-rich composter. So it actually produces 10% of compost within 24 hours. So it's not like you have to wait for months or something. In just 24 hours, you will get 10% of compost out of whatever you are putting in. And it is it minimizes the labor uses and it reduces the energy consumption by 15%. Okay. So it makes the building more self-sustainable.
Great.
Then coming to the training center, as training center, this is performing arts center. So people does not just want to stay inside the classrooms and enjoy whatever they are doing. They actually want to go out and can, so that they have this flexibility of having this spill out areas or the terrace areas where they can just go out and start playing or start dancing. And they, this environment itself, because nature is a great teacher.
Yes.
As I say, so they can easily look around, they'll have that feeling and they can easily express their feelings or their artistic expressions over there. So I have given these terraces on the training center and the details of the terrace garden has been shown over here. So it can also be seen in my 3D. So different types of terraces are developed on all the places so that people can just move out and they also just, if they get like, it does not become a boring place for them. They can see daily a new thing because nature keeps evolving, nature keeps changing. So if we are between the nature, the place itself start changing and we start experiencing that space in a different way.
Absolutely.
Then for the, like, because it is very hot climate in Gurgaon, I actually use the jali patterns and lured patterns in the walls. So the jali patterns is jali pattern does not just have this climatic importance, it also has this historical importance.
Yes.
So as like jali has been historically very important in Indian culture.
Yes.
So this becomes a very important part to show the culture to the generation who are coming.
Yes.
So I have used the jali patterns, which has historical and climatic importance. It also acts as a cooling device. It cut down the heat and glare. It lets the ventilation. So there is cool air which is coming inside from the jali patterns. And it also let the privacy to be maintained. And also acoustically, because Performing Arts Center has to put so much attention to the acoustics, instead of putting all these artificial material for the acoustic, if we try to build more plants and more jali patterns and all, then they also control the acoustics of the place. So that's why the jali patterns have been used. This is the west elevation. So as I talked about west elevation, we have the planter over here, and this is the louvered walls. So this is the blown up of this area. So we have the louvers, and beside this there is planter. So wherever wind passes, because of the louvers and green areas, the hot winds actually converts to the cool wind and cools down the area, which reduces the need for the air conditioning. So I just have my air conditioning in my auditoriums, but not on all other places. Like my rooms and my classrooms are having adaptive cooling system, which is much better than the AC.
Yes.
And then air conditioners. And the jali wall patterns has been used here. And they show east and west, east and south elevation. In east elevation, majorly vertical louvers and jalis have been used. And in south elevation, jali and horizontal chajjas have been used. Great. So that the glares can be cut down. Then this just shows the basement, the number of cars. When I studied about Triveni Kala Sangam, it was that Triveni does not have a particular place for the cars to go and stop, which reduces its usage by 10 to 20% usage of the place is reduced by just not giving a proper parking system.
Yes.
So I have given two basements over there so that if 4,600 people are coming and using, at least 700 cars will come daily over there. So they can easily be accommodated inside in the basement areas, and also for all the other services like STP, BMS room and pump room, other rooms can be easily accommodated in the basement.
Yes.
Then talking about the technological part, like the truss system inside the auditorium, actually I have used the flat truss system so that the terrace of the auditorium can also be used. Okay. Also, this truss system has one drawback, which is it actually, if there is large span, like my span is 64 meters.
Yes.
So if there is large span, there is large span, then the depth also increases.
Yes.
So the depth of this truss becomes 1600 to 1800.
Yes.
So I have tried to use that negative point as a plus point so that anyhow we need catwalks in the auditoriums.
Yes.
So why not use these truss system only as the catwalks?
Brilliant.
So all my services can run through this, and also it can be used as my catwalk system.
Right.
So here this one shows the catwalk. So I just covered the down portion of the truss, and then this can be used as a catwalk system over here.
Great.
Also about the acoustic, I have done the wall sections, which shows the usage of acoustic plastics, acoustic plasters and wood wool, acoustic tiles and other acoustic materials inside the auditoriums. So all other places, planters and jali walls have been put, but because auditorium has lot of acoustic required, some of the acoustics can be managed from there, but not all. So these sound absorbing materials have been put, the wood particle board, etc., have been put to manage the acoustics.
Right.
Then because it is I wanted to give so much importance to the flexibility, keeping in mind the different ways of performances and the freedom needed while performing. So you does not actually, for all other spaces, it's not like for music you just need this kind of space.
Right.
You need to have the flexibility so that people can use, whoever is using that space, they can use it according to their requirement. So the flexibility is very important. So all the areas, all the rooms, all the classrooms have been designed which are very flexible in use. And also the multipurpose hall has this retractable seating. So retractable seating is basically which comes out on the push of a button and it goes inside. So when it goes inside, you will get this plain hall, where you can use the hall as required. Like you can use it as a rehearsal room maybe. And when you want to have it like an auditorium, you can pull those seatings. So it comes out as a seating and then you can use that space.
Right.
Similarly, for the ventilation system, because auditorium was the only space where I have used the air conditioning. There also, I tried to minimize the air conditioning. So all the seaters have the air conditioned ducts which are below their seats, from where the cool air is passed and the hot air can be removed from up, like from the high ceiling. And similarly for the stage, stage has this mid-level grills which is dug around, and from there the air conditioned, the cool air has been supplied, and then from the ceiling the hot air can be removed. Okay. So there can be the circulation maintained.
Great.
Then I have used the solar panels. So in solar panel also use two types of solar panel. One is BIPV, okay, which is building integrated photovoltaics.
Right.
So it actually is very important, as you does not require, like if you are using that solar panel in place of a window, you does not require a window. So it right. reduces the cost of a particular material right. and also the labor use, which is supposed to make that which is supposed to make that window or make that particular place where BIPV is used.
Yes.
So BIPV has been used, and also this pergola system has been used. Like it is a space frame pergola on which the solar panel has been put, so that these panels can in twice a year they can adjust their angles.
Yes.
So it increases the efficiency by 5%.
Right.
So if you are putting one solar panel which can change the angle, and if you are putting 10 solar panel, they will generate equal energy. So this is very beneficial if you put something which can actually change angle twice a year.
Right.
So according to the calculation, 81% of my indoor energy requirement can just be met through these alone. And right. then some through the piezoelectronic. So almost 90% of my energy requirement can be just met through solar panel and piezoelectronic devices.
Right. Understood.
Then talking about the rainwater harvesting, so I have the water harvesting tank which is being used as a water body. So during the summer when there is no water or something, this can be filled up. But during other seasons, the water whichever is harvested can only go and fill this tank up. And even the roof system has these green areas and soft paved areas. So my hard paved and soft paved areas, all these generates approximately 12% of water
right.
can be met through rainwater harvesting in my design.
Right.
And there is STP and overhead tanks for the other requirements.
Right.
So the STP also has like 7% of the water requirement can be met through STP alone.
Right.
Then the material, because Delhi or the Gurgaon comes in earthquake zone, so yes. it comes in seismic zone 4. So for that, I try to use rat trap bond, and I have this band of concrete which is running on the sill level and on the upper level, so that they connect everything. So if you use rat trap bond along with the connection, it provides insulation, as well as it is very beneficial in the earthquake region, and it reduces the chances of falling a building by 70%.
Yes.
So that makes the building much more efficient and much more strong.
Yes.
Also, in case of material usage, I tried to use fly ash bricks, as it costs 20% less and it is environmental friendly.
Yes.
So because it has low water penetration and it comes in uniform sizes, so mortar joints and everything can be managed. Also, while making it, there is very less carbon emission. So the ozone layer does not get that much damage. The greenhouse gases can be reduced to a great extent if we use this instead
yes.
of normal bricks.
Absolutely.
Also, because because it is a performing arts center and so many people are using it, their safety is very important.
Yes.
So the fire tender can actually access all the places, like around all the buildings and from all the sites. the fire tender can access the buildings so that during the fire or during any mishappenings, easily the required attention can be given to the person or to the place.
Yes.
So this shows the, like, I try to use so many different landscaping elements so that people, it's not just about the built form, it's also about the nature, it's also about the greens over there. So each greens is not just a, like, common space, okay, this is the green, public green, private green, but also each green provide you the different kind of experience. So yes, you have OAT space where you, people can just go out and informally they can perform. You have this shaded walkway going all around. And if you are walking undersided, you actually can feel the greens all around you and the flowers and the climbers over there. Then you have the terrace gardens. You have space frame. You have water body over there. And pergola sculpture court is there. So all these spaces make the place, give the place a very different feel.
Yes, very vibrant.
Then some of the view, yeah, and then I just have some of the views from my very, site. Very so nice, this is nice. About the hostel and learning center.
The pergola is coming very this beautiful.
This is the
yeah. The solar panel has not only become very useful item. It is also looking very beautiful. You know, it's creating very beautiful also effect.
So it's function and aesthetics both merging together and coming into being.
Absolutely.
I try to keep the plate, the color palette very simple, like not so vibrant or something, because the people who are using that space or the greens and the other things which are there, they will make the place more vibrant.
Absolutely.
So keeping the color palette plain and simple makes the place more serene as well as vibrant. So both can come together and can have, like, they can easily be merged together, vibrance as well as serene environment.
Great.
Then this is the residential block. So all the residential have this pergola and the greens inside all the balconies and all. And also they have these shaded, all the places are almost shaded so that the inside environment is much controlled.
Right.
Then this is the water body with a hostel block at this back. This is the pergola and the terrace roof garden, which I was talking about. So the terrace also had this gardens and the other areas where people can sit. They can have this as a spill out areas. They can enjoy the place. They can come, they can play the songs. They can dance over there. Like, they can perform, they can express their feelings out.
Absolutely.
So this is the entry to the hostel block, which has on one side, it has jali wall. On one side, it has the green areas. So it's like a transitional space from open to the built, to the inside the hostel block.
Right.
Then this is the sculpture court. So you have different sculptures over here and you have this walking pergola from where, and then the greens all around. You can just sit over there and forget all your worries and just make yourself calm, meditate. Like, it will give a meditation sort of feeling over there. Then this is the covered corridor. This is from the hostel balcony, the view from hostel balcony, which shows the pergolas and even the space frame and the pergolas over here and the greens.
Yes.
Then this is another view from hostel balcony showing the OAT. And this is the overall plan. Yeah. Thank you.
Brilliant, brilliant. I mean, this is amazing work. So, there are a few points, like, this is a building that can be immediately be built, it is just ready. Everything has been taken care of. And, the way you have used landscape, the way you have used jali, jali is quite an old concept, but it has been used with it has been blended so nicely with the whole concept that it just, all the stereotype of the jali is gone. It just looks very contemporary, very nicely done. Something that can be built immediately is what immediately comes to my mind, and a lot of hard work done. I can see, every small little detail has been worked on. All the views have been made beautifully. All the plans are absolutely in place. I think a lot of rework, the evolution, there were so many diagrams that were visible in the evolution. So probably at every step you thought so much. So very good work. I really want to you know, see this kind of a building being built there. So probably you should write to the Gurugram council or something and show them your design, so they should actually, you know, get this thing constructed there. So really, really good work. I mean, I really want to congratulate you for your great
thank design. You so much.
Yeah, so I mean,
thank you.
Yeah, I'm so happy to see this work. So great, I'm so happy.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Shivani.